No discussion of Massachusetts' top natural wonders is complete without a mention of its highest peak, Mount Greylock in Adams. Or the famous potholes along the Deerfield River in Shelburne Falls out in the Mohawk Trail. Then there is the state's highest waterfall, Bashbish Falls, tucked away in the tiny remote town of Mount Washington near the New York-Connecticut border. So beautiful and yet so far. Fortunately, waterfall chasers in eastern Massachusetts aren't completely out of the game if they're willing to make a day of it. Just head to Royalston in northern Worcester County and you will find a waterfall trifecta. That's right, Royalston, about an hour north of Worcester, might be crowned king of the Cascades. There is Doan's Falls, a series of powerful drops on Lawrence Brook. Deeper in the woods, Royalston Falls, with its dramatic 50-foot horsetail plunge into a deep gorge. Last and most remote, Spirit Falls, where the melody of water spilling over rock is nothing short of inspiring. We find Wynn Reidebach of Northampton, streamside.
I love to get outside and play outside. It's great. The water, you know, speaks. I speak back to it.
The waterfalls of Royalston are a favorite of the Appalachian Mountain Club's Bridget Likely.
I mean, you get a lot for a little bit of travel. You get three waterfalls that are absolutely beautiful.
Likely works on the New England National Scenic Trail, a 250-mile hiking path from the Long Island Sound in Connecticut up to its endpoint at Royalston Falls.
A lot of people think they have to go up to the Whites or to Acadia National Park in Maine to get big nature in New England. But in Massachusetts, we have so many hidden gems that I'm so happy we have the opportunity to go to.
All three Royalston waterfalls are trustees' properties, and Likely's favorite?
I mean, I'm a little biased because I work on the New England National Scenic Trail, and Royalston Falls is the terminus of our trail there, so I'm going to go ahead and say Royalston.
Our next natural wonder can't help but leave a lasting impression.
It's the first place I ever came to see dinosaur footprints, and the guy said, well, these are 200 million years old. And then you're hearing traffic go by. And it's, the cognitive dissonance is really, it's kind of profound, actually.
It's an unlikely spot for an earth-shaking discovery. Off an embankment by busy Route 5 in Holyoke, the trustees Dinosaur Footprints Reservation. Sarah Doyle, an independent scholar, tells us the word dinosaur didn't even exist when these tracks were discovered by Edward Hitchcock in the mid-1800s.
I mean, this was international news in the scientific community right away. Certainly put Amherst on the map, scientifically. And Charles Darwin knew about these things.
The Connecticut River Valley, once a subtropical swamp, is where the study of dinosaurs actually began. The collection at the Bineski Museum at Amherst College, the finest of its kind in the world.
I've always loved dinosaurs. Dinosaurs were always very intriguing to me.
Gina Bordoni was such a dino fan, she quit her job as a first grade teacher and opened up shop.
The shop is designed to help kids and families discover the world of natural history.
The Rock Fossil and Dinosaur Shop in Deerfield is a gold mine of minerals, crystals, and dinosaur tracks, as well as interactive activities like panning and fossil digs. Of the 25 life-sized dinosaurs out back, a clear favorite.
Coelophysis, which is our local hero here.
Many of the tracks in the Pioneer Valley are thought to be those of this guy, Coelophysis.
It looks so cute, right? It looks like it's smiling and, you know, you just want to go right up to it. But make no mistake, Coelophysis were fierce. It had razor sharp teeth and they were fast. They weren't really to be messed with. But it does look really super cute in the forest.
Meanwhile, back at the Quincy quarries, our patience pays off. We finally catch some taggers in the act, spray cans in hand. But on closer inspection, we get a lesson in jumping to conclusions.
So we're just basically going around and covering the swear words and either turning them into something else or, you know, just making it appropriate.
Lisa and Kaylee, a mother-daughter tag team from Braintree. The cleanup, daughter Kaylee's idea.
When I came here, there was a lot of swear words and I couldn't take many like fun pictures or anything, so I thought, why not block out the swear words?
Natural wonders, indeed.